Is it better with this or without it? It is better. Okay, just a few words about a magic hat. You can expect mistakes. Now there's a reason for that. There's several reasons. One is that there are 8 ways you can put a square slide in the lantern. Only one of the 8 is correct. Secondly, we work in the dark. Thirdly,
no rehearsal.
All the slides have to go upside down. And the only information Robin has got is on this part of the slide that will be at the bottom. So there's no way he can read the information unless he can remember it. So don't expect, too much. Things will go wrong. Well, maybe not. He's a very, very good lanternist. Anyway, that's my introduction, giving him time to get set up. Now, can we have some blackout? We need all the lights off. I'd like all those lights up there turned off. I'd like daylight to disappear quickly from the doors.
We want it to dark. The sun off. We have the sun turned down.
Maybe if we have a cloudy day. Not looking good. Ah.
Oh.
That's more like excellent. Yeah, well, thank you so much. And I'll hand you over to Robin as soon as he's ready. Thanks, sir. Thank you.
Well, we've got 3 groups of slides this morning. The first lot are the donations that were commented on in the latest newsletter, which prompted, when I read it about the discovery of slides, I thought, oh, that's really interesting. I wonder if we could project them. I never expected that within just 5 days that we're here and showing those slides. We've had a quick look at them this morning. They're a pretty mixed bag. Some of them appear to be WI meetings and such like. So we filtered out those that are more on topic. They're in a fairly random order, so not quite sure what's coming. The very first slide from this set is this title slide, which is quite unusual to have one. And off we go.
They all want to be fighter pilots when they grow up nowadays. Obviously, 1930s, wondering where they're going to get the next drivers from.
Can anyone tell us, is that 467?
Yeah, looks like 467, T26
to Edinburgh. Roughly what sort of date?
Well, it's Great Eastern Era, clearly. We need Lynn here to tell what the difference is in the number of coal rails and things. Tell you what year it might be, but... Yeah.
Now, this is a hymn. I don't suppose you can read it, but... It'd be interesting to, if you've got a good singer who can stand there, look at it, and read it, sing it out for us.
Quite often at Magic Lantern meetings, you'll have someone who wants to give some more entertainment by actually singing.
Is that the railway mission?
Yes, that's exactly that.
The information ecology,
I think it was also on the introductory slide.
Yes, I think it was.
That is how it was originally, apparently. What I can remember.
Next one is Lowestoft.
Order of 15.
1500 to me is clearly on express, without having access to the slide text.
This is a guard at Clapham.
He says guard Clapham, but I wondered that's his name rather than the station.
Yeah, because Clapham is not GER territory, is it?
No. It's a GER uniform. I can't quite see it from here.
The ambulance team.
Where's that bus stop? Is that Queen Victoria?
Oh, see, yes, someone dressed as Queen Victoria in the middle, isn't it?
SS Superintendent E.W. Bowden.
With his wife. He also did the Sunday school, apparently, from the other side, I've seen.
Got the superintendent again. Oh. Possibly in retirement.
That's the one where it says Sunday school on this slide.
Oh, it's SS's Sunday school. Station staff, 1900.
Gosh.
Which station?
Lots of them, aren't there? Right.
1551 wasn't many of those stations. No, so it won't be a big station. This would be a relatively modest station. And Colchester would certainly have more than that. Remember some of the other pictures we had in the journal where the Bishop Stockton and even all the end, you know, huge numbers all turning out.
Probably just one on the park.
This next slide is labelled Westerfield accident. I don't know anything about that. Where's Westerfield?
Just outside of Ipswich.
Oh, right.
In the southern line. That's the Westerfield boiler explosion.
This is the infamous 1905 Witham accident. In fact, I've got exactly the same slide.
Good Lord.
I think it was very...
Yes, I get the impression that the mission acquired some slides as well as, made their own.
More of Witten. Am I right in thinking that was the Cromer Express?
Cromer Express one, yeah.
More disaster, the Colchester disaster. Presumably after the accident, it's off to here, the mission hall. Guard, David King. I'm not sure if I'm reading this right. This is a good shed. Fire. It appears to say hive, unless I'm misreading it.
Hide or hive?
I suppose it could be.
Good shed fire, anyone?
Hold on, try and have a look.
It's got like a superintendent. Seven deadly mistakes, but it's not actually clear. Yes, it says preaching.
Focus.
Yeah, it's
some kind of can. Yeah. Yes, yeah, she's playing a an instrument of some sort.
Yeah.
I forgot what this one is then. Oh yes. This one's a bit off topic. It's the last tram.
Oh yeah, it's quite
early. That's Colchester's last tram.
Colchester's last train.
That's just next to Colchester Station, isn't it?
See, those last people, you might not have small, called Colchester Train.
Well, I was going to say, look, it was a miniature train.
They were there, I think.
They weren't very big.
Oh, right. Which way? Changing the scene, traveling.
Yes.
So that's, again, that would take up on the railway in Colchester, looking through to the hotel.
The constant of the just before the Second World War.
Right, so this is the one that is Colchester North Station in 1876.
It says...
This is the railway hotel there on the right. And what's interesting is you can see they're starting to build houses along the roads there. Yeah. And those houses are still there if you look on the modern aerial maps. Of course, the railway hotel is now sitting under a roundabout. But if anybody identified a locomotive,
it's a Sinclair 240.
See, I thought it was a Sinclair 240, but when you look in detail, it's not quite right.
Well, they were rebuilt quite substantially.
Yeah, I suspect. I have asked Lynn for his opinion on that, but so he's not come back to me.
Did you Patrick, my brother, died?
It is in their era.
You've enjoyed this.
Driver Bates on 477.
It looks like 467. The one we've seen before on the T26. This is typical of a lot of their images of staff lining up in front of their engines. Yeah. Although when I try to digitally scan that to try and improve it, it's slightly blurred.
Ipswich Station.
Yes.
Yeah, the country end.
Mm. Yes, it would be.
How long would the exposures be on these photos?
Well, the old ones, quite long. This one looks more modern to me. But could be wrong, I'm not quite sure what we're looking at there.
It looks pretty crisp on the smoke, I'm thinking.
Yeah, yeah.
That's true.
This is Clacton.
Oh, look at that.
There are the cleaners.
741.
Yeah, rebuilt one to Dutch.
It could be a rebuilt one, yeah.
Is the number clear on that one, Peter?
It's 741.
Can you try to focus it a bit better? They're asking for the number.
Now we've got a minister come to bless a locomotive.
Well, that's what that can be.
We've got a second photograph of staff in front of this engine.
Right, this is what we had in the news. This is James Holden and his wife. And there are remarkably few pictures of James Holden in his character. Obviously, the image you saw in the journal, I removed some of the strange artifacts coming out of his head. no, as I say, if you Google around, I've searched in one image that all websites have of James Holden.
Robin's already recorded.
This is James Holden, the logo designer, is it?
Indeed, James Holden, the famous logo designer. The only second photograph of him is in the top hat in front of the desk, but it's so tiny you can't see his face at all. That's a nice image.
Colchester station staff.
That is stood in front of a horse box.
Yeah.
And then we've got the fitters.
Yes, the fitters in front of a K2. The Indian looking chap with a funny cap on in the middle. I couldn't work out if he was a railway worker or something to do with the mission. But it's not a brilliant slide, and I tried to sharpen it up.
Sorry, can I make a suggestion? Yes. The guy who's doing all the talking, we can't hear you very well at the back. Do you want to use the microphone? Oh, that's better.
Coming back to the Colchester accident. Was that 1913, I think, was it?
1913, yeah.
Is that a B-12?
That's it, yeah.
Freddy. Yeah. Six.
And it didn't survive, did it?
It's the football team. Signal box.
Again, this is a nice one that I would be put in the news that I digitally scanned. And we think that's a RAL mission man in the middle because he's not wearing the uniform as such. It's a nice clear slide.
Not sure if it's the same one or not.
No.
Slide earlier of the
Too early. Stop to the logo there.
We had a slide earlier of the Hive
Fire. Is that the cathedral on the right? You can go back. No, no.
So this is the fire again, isn't it?
Hive.
Hive Fire.
Miss J. Chitten and the Loco Men.
Ah, yes, again, that's one that I have scanned that, and you can improve the contrast, see more of the detail, because that's fine. Again, another T26, but yes, the lady there is getting from the mission. And,
is anything known about the lady?
Chitten.
Chitten.
This one simply says trio at Loco.
Oh, that's the other photograph I mentioned where I saw that white mark on the